नमस्ते स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम बैक अगेन विद माय नेक्स्ट वीडियो ऑन द सेम टॉपिक एडवर्ब्स। एज यू नो इन माय प्रीवियस वीडियो ऑन एडवर्ब्स आई हैव डिस्कस्ड फोर टाइप्स ऑफ एडवर्ब्स एज आई हैव ऑलरेडी रिटन ऑन द बोर्ड। द फर्स्ट वन इज एडवर्ब ऑफ मैनर व्हिच गिव्स द आंसर ऑफ हाउ। द सेकंड वन इज एडवर्ब ऑफ प्लेस व्हिच गिव्स द आंसर ऑफ वेयर। थर्ड वन इज adverb of time which gives the answer of when, and the fourth one is adverb of frequency which tells us how often the action takes place. Today I am going to start the next type of adverb, which is adverb of purpose. Adverb of purpose. In adverb of purpose, and we also call it adverb of reason. So adverb of reason. Adverb of reason. In this type of adverb, always gives the answers for why. This type of adverbs tells us why the action takes place in the sentence. Why the action takes place in the sentence. You will understand it by looking at examples. So keep looking at the board. The first example is I was sick, thus didn't go to work today. Didn't go to work today means he was giving the reason why he didn't go at work, because he was sick. That's why he didn't go at work, and thus here is adverb. So this type of adverbs always shows us why the action takes place in the sentence. Look at more examples. I started jogging so that I wouldn't be late. He started jogging. Jogging means running. So he started jogging so that he wouldn't be late. He was giving the reason why he started jogging, because he do not want it to be late. That's why. And so that is given in the sentence. So that is an adverb in the sentence. Now next example is put on your warm clothes. Lest you should catch the chill. He was giving the reason. Put on your warm clothes, lest you should catch the chill. He means to say that if you will not put on warm clothes during the winter, it means you will be suffered from cold. And so lest is the adverb here. And the next one is we eat that we may live. That is the adverb in the sentence. Why we eat? He was giving the reason. What is the purpose behind eating? Purpose behind eating so that we could survive, because without food we cannot survive. So in the sentence, we eat that we may live is giving the reason. And I think I have given you sufficient examples to prove my points, and everything is clear to you. And now I hope that you all will got that how to recognize adverb clause of purpose or reason. Now come to the next clause, next adverb. The next adverb is The next adverb is adverb of. The next adverb is adverb of degree. Adverb of degree. This type of adverbs shows the intensity and amount of an action in the sentence. Amount and intensity of an action in the sentence. So these adverbs tells us the amount or intensity of the action in the sentence. So look at the examples. The first example is, if I say that the old man ate little. The old man ate little. She is very beautiful. She is very beautiful. The water is extremely cold. The water is extremely cold. He almost always late. If I say, listen students, if I say she is beautiful, this is a very simple sentence. But if I say she is very beautiful, it means she is very is explaining the intensity of the word beautiful. The next is, if I say the water is hot, this is very simple, the water is hot. If I say the water is extremely hot, it is telling us the amount of hotness into the water or intensity of the hotness. And the second is, he almost always late. If I say he is always late. Sorry, I forgot to write is. He is almost always late. If I say he is always late, this is also simple. But to increase the intensity of my words, so I use almost. Almost is the adverb. So almost increase the intensity of the word that he regularly comes late. He has never been on time even on a single day. That's why I have used almost. I think it is clear to you. So this is adverb clause of a degree, which explains us the amount and intensity of a action in the sentence. And look at these examples. Go through them again and again. Definitely you will understand whatever I am telling you. Now come to the next adverb. Next adverb is adverb of duration. Adverb of a duration. In this type of adverbs, adverb of a duration. Adverb of durations. These adverbs tells us how long the action takes place. These adverbs tells us how long the action takes place. How long the action takes place? For example, the actor appeared briefly on the stage. The actor appeared briefly on the stage. Means for how long? This sentence is giving the answer of how long. How long the actor appeared on the stage briefly, for a short time. For a short term, for a few minutes you can say, not for a long time. In this sentence, briefly is explaining that how long the actor appeared on the stage briefly is telling us the duration of the time for which the actor appeared on the stage. So briefly is adverb in the sentence. This type of adverbs tells us the duration and how, and always gives the answer of how long. If I say Kyle and Jane rode their horses. Rode their horses all day. Means Kyle and Jane was riding their horses for the complete day. Means telling the duration. Kyle and Jane rode their horses all day. So this is also telling us the duration of the time in the sentence. I think the adverb of duration is clear to you. Again, I am going to explain. The actor appeared briefly on the stage. I stayed awake all night. Means telling the duration. And Kyle and Jane rode their horses all day. The next one is, the next adverb is interrogative adverb. The next type of adverb are interrogative adverbs. Interrogative adverbs. And I think you all are already aware of this type of adverbs, because daily in our daily life, in our routine life, we used to ask a lot of questions from each other by using these adverbs. So these adverbs are used to ask questions. These adverbs are used to ask questions. For example, how deep is the river? How deep is the river? Means he is asking a question about the depth of a river. The second is where you have been. Where you have been. This is also asking a question. And the third one is when the house was built. Where are you going? So when you will read all these sentences, so immediately you will come to know that these questions, these adverbs are asking a question in the sentence. So immediately you will recognize that these are adverbs, interrogative adverbs. Like how long, how deep is the river, asking the question about the depthness of the river. Where you have been, and where you have been, he is asking the question because he has seen him after a long time. That's why, where you have been. When the house was built, he was asking that when this house was built, where you are going. Just this is a very simple question in our daily life. We used to ask earlier, where you are going. So these are the interrogative adverbs. And now I think all this topic of adverb is clear to you. I have explained all the kinds of adverbs by giving sufficient examples. Now I am going to write some examples on the board, and you people have to recognize that which kind of adverb is there in the sentence. Now I am going to write the first example. Keep looking at the board. The first example I am going to write is like tomorrow our fate will be sealed. Fate will be sealed tomorrow. So you have to tell me that which type of adverb is this. Which type type of adverb is this, and then we will write the type of adverb in this sentence in this bracket. And the, again I'm going to write next one is I have been to Kerala. I have been to Kerala just once. So you have to write this one. Next is you drive badly. Next is walk carefully on the pavement. Walk carefully on the pavement. You have to recognize that which type of adverb, which kind of adverb is used in the sentence. I have never been to Goa. I have never been to. I have never been to Goa. And the next is I have. He usually go for a walk in the garden. He usually go for a walk in the garden. They watch English movies quite often. They watch English movies quite often. So look at the first sentence, and then I will tell you that which kind of adverb is used in the sentence. Tomorrow our fate will be sealed. Tomorrow is the next day. It is indicating towards a time. Tomorrow is indicating towards a time. So this is adverb of time. The next one is I have been to Kerala just once. Means he has been to Kerala just once. He never stayed there for 2 or 3 days. It is giving the answer of how long you stayed there. How many times you visited there. So how long this is? I have been to Kerala just once. This is giving the answer of how long. So adverb of duration. This is adverb of duration. You drive badly. Give me the answer of how. How you drive? I drive very badly. Give me the answer of how. Then this is adverb of manner. Adverb of manner. And walk carefully on the pavement. How you walk? Carefully. Give me the answer of how you have to walk on the pavement. Carefully. Then this is also adverb of manner. Adverb of manner. I have never been to Goa. Means telling us about the place. So this is adverb of place. He never been to Goa. Adverb never is telling us that he never ever visited Goa in his life. So that's why it is telling us, indicating towards a place. This is adverb of place for sure. And I usually is an adverb used in the sentence. I usually go for a walk in the garden. It is an adverb. How often you go in the garden? Usually is daily you used to go into the garden. So this is adverb of frequency. This is adverb of frequency. So the last sentence for today, the last sentence is they watch English movies quite often. They watch English movies quite often. So often is a adverb in the sentence. Quite often, this is also this is sentence is giving the answer of how often. Then this is also adverb of frequency. So dear students, this is all from my side, and I hope you all understand these adverbs. I have explained all parts, all kinds of adverbs, by giving sufficient examples with patients. And if you have any query regarding this topic, you can SMS me in the group, and I am going to send you a PDF file of the assignments on the basis of these adverbs. Thank you. Have a nice day. Stay safe.